So, hello everyone, and welcome back to another video. Today we're diving into 10 free to-do list applications that are on the market right now. Now, as you can imagine, to-do list applications are traditionally between sort of $1 and $4 a month. But as you can imagine, when it comes to free applications, what ones are actually available? Because what we'll do in today's video is include free ones and free ones with paid upgrades in this list. Free ones are actually harder to come across than you think. Now, as you can imagine, paid applications in the third-party space tend to help support sustainability and growth. And sometimes a free application might present other ways, for example, like ads and tips that, for example, might not actually give you the most free experience of them all. So we're going to give you an order of the most free to start and then finish with some of those free ones with paid models a little later. So as you can imagine, if you're new here, please do hit subscribe and feel free to comment below, because this video came from one of our users who recommended checking out free ones. So feel free to subscribe, and as you can imagine, feel free to jump in the comments below. So the first one on our list is actually a Microsoft solution. Now, a while ago, an application called Wunderlist, which was a free to-do list application that did have a premium upgrade, got bought by Microsoft, and they turned it into Microsoft To-Do. Now, if you have a Microsoft account, you can get access to Microsoft To-Do for free, and there's no real limitations unless you're looking to connect it to, for example, a Microsoft plan or Microsoft subscription, which does add more of the pricing, and those integrations come in later. However, if you want to use Microsoft To-Do, hypothetically, it can be entirely free with no ads and no confusing upgrades for later. The second on our list is very similar. It's Google Tasks. And if you don't know, Google actually have their own Tasks application, which is available on Android and iOS. And it does come with a sort of web version, but there's no ads, it is free to use, and there's even no upgrades for you to worry about. But Google Tasks presents actually a really handy feature for Gmail users. If you haven't yet checked out our video at how to create a Google task from a Gmail, this is really helpful because you can turn any email into a task really easily whilst being on the web. So Google Tasks are a great alternative if you're in that Google ecosystem. Up next is Apple Reminders, and this comes pre-built and installed inside of every iOS application. This comes pre-built and available inside of every new iPhone. You can actually now delete this application from your phone, but Apple Reminders presents a really functional way to create a to-do, add a due date, and be able to get started straight away. Now, on iOS, there's an application called Do, and it's Do with an exclamation mark, but it's a very simple reminders-based to-do list application that actually has ads inside of it that I believe can be removed for about $5, and there's an optional tip that could come in, but obviously we're not promoting it because it's free. We're trying to keep this one free as possible, but as you can imagine, it does have a free experience for managing your reminders, keeping track of your to-dos, and planning ahead. So that's just something to note. Number five is another Google solution, and it does have an entirely free experience. Google Keep has a great way to start making checklists and just get yourself started with some basic to-dos. Now, it doesn't work, in my opinion, as well as a to-do list as Google Tasks does, but the benefit is you can use a checklist, a note for a task, to be able to use it alongside of your notes that you create, sort of like a post-it note library inside of Google Keep. So that's one of the reasons I recommend it above, say, Google Tasks sometimes, if you're looking to create notes alongside of it. Okay, so now we're gonna talk about four applications that are paid. Well, they have a paid version, but they do have a free version. But as you can imagine, there are some limitations. So number six on our list is TickTick. And it is a free application, but it does have some limitations in terms of your list, task, subtask count, etc. So for example, when you're creating lists inside of the free version of TickTick, you can only create up to 9 lists with 99 tasks per list, and 19 tasks, subtasks per task, and only two reminders and one attachment. So there are some limitations here. However, this is actually a pretty decent bet because sometimes we don't typically use a lot of these and we normally tick off tasks. So for example, that task count of 99 per list actually excludes completed tasks. And normally we don't have more than 99 in our list. So TickTick is a great solution for that. Looking next, number seven, we've got Zenkit To-Do. Now Zenkit To-Do is actually got a personal plan and you can not just add yourself to it, but you can add up to 8 people for free. And it has 500 megabytes of attachments, which is pretty decent, up to 100 lists. So that's much more than, for example, the 9 that you get inside a TickTick, and up to 10,000 tasks. And you don't have to pay for this, which is absolutely fantastic. Now, you can naturally get all of the other features that you typically get inside of the basic plan, like, for example, reminders, comments, and file uploads, but you won't get some of the stuff like recurring tasks, tags, and user roles. And this is pretty common with most of the free stuff. And that's something to remember inside of TickTick as well. There are some account limitations. However, being able to add up to 10,000 tasks is pretty decent, especially against just 99 for the other one. Now, Any.DO do have another alternative as our number 8. They have a free plan, which does allow you to get access to all of their regular features, minus, for example, their advanced recurring tasks, location-based reminders, focus mode, and even some limitations on their feature called Moments. And backgrounds and themes become compromised if you go for the free plan. But as you can imagine, it's pretty much that I haven't seen any limitations you get with their Any.DO plan in terms of how many tasks you can add. There are limitations when it comes to file upload, like 1.5 megabyte per file, but definitely a good solution if you're looking at no limitations for your own plans. Next up, another fantastic all-rounder is Todoist. And in their free plan, they have a fairly generous experience with 5 active projects you can have, active tasks you can have up to 300 per project, and you can have 20 sections. You can also collaborate with up to 5 people per project, but the file upload is a little low at 5 megabytes, but in comparison with Any.DO at 1.5 meg, it's a little bit better. You do get filter views at 3, and you don't get reminders, sadly. This is something you need to upgrade inside of Todoist. Now, our final one is actually ClickUp, and we only recommend this because they've got a really decent free plan. In ClickUp free plan, you can naturally use it as a personal to-do list, so it's a great optional thing, and they do have unlimited users and unlimited guests, I think, as part of that plan, and a fairly reasonable storage amount as well. But you also get access to the majority of the basic project management abilities too. So if you're looking to take it a little bit further, that's beneficial to have that too. Anyway, folks, all of these will be listed in the description below if you want to check them out. And feel free to reach out to me in the comments if you have any questions. But I tried rounding up a few free to-do list applications for you guys to find the best one, save a bit of cash maybe, and find out which one's most suitable for you. Anyway, folks, big, big thank you. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll talk to you all very, very soon. Cheerio.